suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
What does this mean?
I believe that Jesus Christ, true God, begotten of the Father in eternity, and also a true human being, born of the Virgin Mary, is my Lord.
He has redeemed me, a lost and condemned human being.
He has purchased and freed me from all sins, from death, and from the power of the devil, not with gold and silver, but with his holy precious blood, and with his innocent suffering and death.
He has done all this in order that I may belong to him, live under him in his kingdom, and serve him in eternal righteousness, innocence, and blessedness, just as he has risen from the dead and lives and rules eternally.
This is most certainly true.
Have you ever noticed that the second article is a bit like a sandwich without the peanut butter and jelly between the two slices of bread? We hear about Jesus' birth, then we jump immediately to his suffering and death with nothing in the middle. Of course, Jesus' birth is very important to show that he is truly human and also God's Son. And obviously, Jesus' death and resurrection are why we're all here. But it's the stuff between those two end pieces of his life that hold the beginning and the end together, like peanut butter and jelly. It's Jesus' ministry, his healings, his miracles, his teachings and relevant parables that really drew people to him. It was Jesus' love and compassion for people that caused him to matter to people. It was his relationships with the 12 disciples, with the authorities, and with the crowds that taught people about who God is and the lengths God would go to show his love and mercy to the world. Ironically, it was these same relationships with the disciples, the authorities, and the crowds that brought on the suffering, death, and burial that we confess in the second article. But it was because of God's relationship with his people, because of God's love for the world, that Jesus was born. Jesus' whole life was about delivering God's message of love, acceptance, forgiveness, and salvation, which Jesus lived out in his life, his death, and his resurrection. That is why we're here. We're here because Jesus was born for us, because Jesus lived and loved us, because he died so that our sins are forgiven, because Jesus frees us from sin and death, because we are promised eternal life with God after this life ends. We're here because God loving us so much that he gave everything for us inspires us to live life differently. Jesus gave his life for us, so we're called to give our lives to him, not by dying, but by loving him, by serving our neighbors, by telling the world the story of God's love. We're called to remember who Jesus is, what Jesus did for us, and how Jesus calls us to follow his example by striving for justice, by showing compassion, by welcoming outcasts and sinners. Jesus has freed us to live in God's grace rather than about worrying about saving ourselves. And because Jesus always remembered us to the very end and into his resurrection, we set aside time to come and worship, to give thanks, to humbly praise God our whole lives long.